Let us go to the second application of Gauss law, where we are going to find electric field due to an infinitely charged plane sheet. Let us consider an infinite plane charge sheet, where to find the electric field due to this, we will first consider the surface charge density of the sheet to be equal to sigma. Now, we will imagine a pill box or a rectangular body been placed inside the sheet, where half part of it is on one side of the sheet and the other half is on the other part of the sheet. So this imaginary rectangular pill box is going to act as a Gaussian surface for us. Now, this Gaussian surface has two faces, where we have shaded them in green in color to show us phase 1 and phase 2. So the area on both the sides is same, where we have considered the area as delta S. Further, the electric field from the surfaces should be moving out from the surface as shown in the diagram, where it is delta S on this surface and electric field now are making an angle which is equal to 90 degrees between them. Therefore, flux which is equal to E delta S cos theta. We will have both of them perpendicular to each other. Hence, the electric field from this surface should be equal to 0, where cos of 90 should be giving us 0. Hence, we get E delta S into 0, or flux through the rectangular box is 0. So the electric flux, or the total electric flux through this imaginary surface or this pill box, should be due to flux E delta S, which is due to the phase 1, plus E into delta S, which is due to phase 2, where you will get this is 2E into delta S. Therefore, flux is equal to 2E delta S cos theta, where theta now should be the angle between electric field and area vector delta S. What we find out over here is E, which is parallel to delta S, should be giving you theta is equal to 0 degrees. Hence, 2E delta S cos theta is equal to 2ES cos of 0, or cos of 0 is equal to 1. Hence, we get 2E delta S. We'll let us call this as equation 1. Now, according to Gauss theorem, flux is equal to 1 upon epsilon naught into Q, which we'll call it as equation 2. And now, comparing equations 1 and 2, 2E delta S should be equal to 1 upon epsilon naught into Q. So Q is the charge enclosed by the Gaussian surface. Therefore, Q is equal to sigma into delta S, or 2E delta S is equal to 1 upon epsilon naught times sigma into delta S, where we have replaced Q by sigma into delta S, where sigma represents surface charge density. We can strike out delta S on both sides, so we're left with E is equal to sigma upon 2 epsilon naught. Further, since electric field due to an infinite charge plane sheet, which is given as E is equal to sigma upon 2 epsilon naught, we would get vectorally electric field is equal to sigma upon 2 epsilon naught into n cap, or E is directed outwards if sigma is positive, and E is directed inwards if sigma is negative.